We are in continuation with the next topic of the unit first of TCCM, which is introductory concept. So today we will discuss the next topic. So today's topic is performance measures. Network performance refers to the measurement of service quality of a network achieved by the customer, right? So what kind of quality is being provided for the customers? There are many different ways to measure the performance of a network, as each network is different in nature and design. The following measures are often considered important. First is the bandwidth, throughput, latency, jitter, error rate, right? We'll discuss them one by one. Bandwidth, commonly measured in bits per second, is the maximum rate that data, the information can be transferred. Next is throughput, is the actual rate that data is transferred. Next, latency, the delay between the sender and the receiver decoding it. That is mainly a function of a signal's travel time and processing time at any nodes the information traverses. Next is jitter, the variation and packet delay at the receiver of the information. And the last is error rate, the number of corrupted bits expressed as the percentage or fraction of the total. So these are the five basic concepts of the for measuring the performance of the network. So like based on these parameters, we can measure the performance of any network. Next is the line coding. This is the next topic. Line coding, or line code, is the code used for data transmission of digital signal over a transmission line. Types of line coding. There are three types of line coding. First is unipolar, polar, and bipolar. Right. So we'll discuss them one by one in detail. Unipolar signaling method. The presence of a pulse represent a 1 and the absence of a pulse represent as 0. Right? So there are two variations in unipolar signaling, not return to 0 and RZ and return to 0. Right? Then the next method is unipolar is further subdivided into the two parts, not return to 0 and not return to 0, which is called NRZ. In this type of unipolar signaling, a high in data is represented by a positive pulse marked as marked, right? So we'll mark it in the graph like positive, in the positive side. Positive pulse, which has a duration of T naught equal to the symbol bit duration, a low in data bit has no pulse. So like we'll discuss here with the diagram over here. So this was the clock and this was the data to be transmitted. For the high pulse we have one, for no pulse we have zero. So like unipolar and RZ will be like not return to zero. So we'll not return to the zero for the one. So we'll continue for the one, and then for the zero no pulse, and again for the one, that for zero zero we'll remain at the low zero x-axis, and then for the ones we will move to the positive side, right? So this was the NRZ. Next is unipolar return to zero. In this type of unipolar signaling, a high in data through though represent by a marked pulse, its duration T naught is less than symbol bit duration. Half of the bit duration remains high, but it immediately returns to zero and shows the absence of pulse during the remaining half of the better duration. So we'll discuss it here with the diagram. Like this is the clock pulse and this is the data. So for the one, whenever one will be transmitted, for the half time it will be the positive, and for the next half it will return to the zero part. So for the one, like it happened for the half part in the positive part, then return to zero, and for the zero no pulse. Similarly again, then one encountered few, it will go again higher than low, and for the zero no pulse, and so on, we can code in this way. So this was the unipolar RZ. Next is polar signaling. There are the two methods of polar signaling. Generally we have two methods, like what we are going to discuss over here, like four methods. फर्स्ट इज पोलर एनआरजेड एंड पोलर आरजेड. पोलर एनआरजेड इन दिस टाइप ऑफ पोलर सिग्नलिंग अ हाई इन डेटा इज रिप्रेजेंटेटिव पर पॉजिटिव पल्स विद अ लो इन अ डेटा इज रिप्रेजेंटेड while a low end data is represented by the negative pulse. So you'll see this is the diagram, like this is what the clock and data for the, like this is the zero axis, this is a positive and negative, like see. So for the one it is from the negative to the positive, for zero it is in the negative, again for the one it is from the positive, and so on we can go this way. Next is polar RZ. In this type of polar signaling, a high-end data, though represented by a marked pulse, its duration denotes less than symbol bit duration. Half of bit duration remains high, but it immediately returns to zero and shows the absence of pulse during the remaining half of the bit duration. However, for a low input, a negative pulse represents the data, and zero level remains same for other half of the bit duration. So we'll see this with the diagram, like over here we have the clock and this is the data. For the half of the time, for the one we have in the positive, and for the next half in the negative, and so on, for the zero negative to positive and positive to negative, and so on we can code this. Next are the two important unipolar methods that are Manchester and differential Manchester encoding. We can say that Manchester encoding is the combination of RZ and NRZL. Here instead of using three values of voltage, we use only two. The logical one is represented in two halves. The first half consists of a negative voltage and second half is represented by a positive voltage. And logical zero is also represented in two halves. The first half consists of a positive voltage and second half is represented by a negative voltage. The differential Manchester encoding can be said as the combination of the RZ and RZI. Here we use the same logic as we use in the NRZI, that is inversion will take place when encounter logical 1, and if we encounter logical 0 then no inversion. So we'll see it with the diagram, like this is for the Manchester, for the half time negative to positive it will go, then for the again 1 it will negative to positive. Then for the zero it will positive to negative, like so. And this is the differential Manchester, you can see it in the diagram. So this was about the polar signaling and polar line coding. Last is the bipolar signaling. This is an encoding scheme, a technique which has three voltage levels, namely plus, negative and zero. Such a signal is called as a duo binary signal. An example of this type is an alternate mark inversion AMI for a 1. The voltage level gets a transition from positive to negative or from negative to positive, have alternate ones to be of equal polarity. A 0 will have a 0 voltage, right? So we can see over here, for the first one encounter will have in the positive, for the 0 no, and for the next one in the negative, and so on. So for the ones we'll have alternate positive, negative, or positive, negative, positive. And for the further data signal, it will continue in the same. Right, so this was all about the like polar signaling and the line coding. In the next class, we'll discuss about the next topic, which is the digital modulation. Like, so thank you so much.